tutti qui su Qui Infanzia Italia Worldwide. Oggi abbiamo un altro ospite bellissimo e straordinario che ha fatto una bellissima carriera insieme a Brian e anche una carriera da solista insieme a Jamie Moses. Ciao Jamie. Ciao Jamie. Per me è una bellissima emozione averti qui. Ti seguo da tanto. Ti ho visto nel 98 a Rolling Stone a Milano con Brian May.
He's saying that he's very excited. We're very excited to have you here, and we've been following you for a long time. And he, my friend here, saw you in 2008 with Bry. Then.
E adesso ti faremo un po' di domande, Jamie, così almeno ci racconti un po' della tua carriera, della tua storia.
Now we're going to ask you some questions so that you can tell us a bit about your career, your story, and things like that.
Perfetto. Ok, Jamie, allora, prima domanda, come sei arrivato a suonare con Brian? Subito così.
First question. It's kind of direct. How did you get to play with Brian?
It was through my old friend Spike Edney, who I've known for, in fact, I was thinking about it just the other day. I've known him for 38 years,
Oh,
I
that's
think
a
it
lot.
is. Well, however long it is, since 1973. Since 1973. So, and he ended up playing with Queen, and I ended up doing other things. And he called up and said that after Freddie died, that Brian was putting this band together, just called the Brian May Band. Would I be interested in coming along for an audition, which I did in London, and I did the audition. It was great meeting Brian and everything. In fact, I met Brian at the Freddie Mercury tribute, where I was playing with Bob Geldof in 1992, was it, I think?
Sì.
And I was playing with Geldof, and Spike took me to meet Brian in his dressing room for the first time. I went, wow, Brian May, fantastic. So, well, like you would, and it was there's a great to meet him there, and then within about 6 months, I guess it was, that audition happened, where I went along, and I remember saying to Brian after the audition, I said, even if I don't get the gig, and you choose somebody else, just playing with you for these. Five, six songs has been the highlight of my life. So I'm not blowing smoke up your ass, but you're one of the five best guitar players ever. So it's a great honor playing with you. And that was that. And they said, okay, well, we just need to talk. And they I waited out in the corridor, came back in, they said, do you want to join the band? I went, yeah, I do.
Allora, ok. Che tipo di persona eri con Brian al di fuori dei concerti? Che rapporto c'era?
Okay, he wants to know what kind of relationship did you have with Brian and the band, but aside from concerts, aside from the work environment?
Oh, it's great. Brian is a he's such a fantastic guy. He's got this brain that retains information. He's so educated, learned, we say, which I don't have really, not like that at all. But we have a similar kind of approach to music in a way, in that, it has to be exactly like this. And I know exactly what he means when he says, no, it's not quite as I think it should be. It should be like this. And I go, yeah, I know what you mean. And we've got similar kind of interests in a lot of things. So that's Brian. Then there was Cozy Powell, who,
Power.
God rest him. He was fantastic. He used to sit up at the front of the bus and shout at other motorists on behalf of the bus driver. You know, he used to get angry at other drivers. the bus driver would just like this and goes, "What are you doing?" He was a funny guy. And Neil Murray, of course, who's fantastic, great bass player and lovely guy. And the girls and Spike, you know, Spike, as I say, is one of my oldest friends. So it was a very happy band, the Brian May Band, if that's what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Ok, Jamie. Allora, com'è stato andare in tour con i Queen nel 2005 fino al 2008? Raccontaci un po' di aneddoti.
Okay, how was it like to tour with Queen from 2005 to 2008? Do you have any particular trivia or story you want to share with us?
It seems like a long time ago. there was so much went on. Of course, the one that is in my mind now is the gig in the Ukraine that we did. That was broadcast, wasn't it? Two days ago. Did you see it?
Mm-hmm.
Live from Ukraine thing.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that was a fantastic gig. The people were so friendly and so warm. It's just awful to think what they're going through now. And that square where we performed, I don't know if there's anything left of it. It's I shouldn't get involved in these things, but just to say that it's one of the most unjust wars that has ever been fought. And he needs to be tried for war crimes. I shouldn't get involved in that. No, forget that. Don't forget all that. But anyway, that's okay. So that's the Ukraine thing. And then we had we went all around the world. We did some gigs in Japan, which were fun, on the bullet train, going stupid miles an hour. When we got to Fukuoka in Japan, I used to live in Japan. I lived there for 2 years when I was 13 or 14, 14, 15, on a US air base, Air Force base, with my dad, you know, with my family. And I got there to Fukuoka, and I said, right, I've got to go and see this place where my band, because I had a band then, played. We played on the roof. We opened this building, department store, and said, I've got to find out. I want to go back to that place. And they kept shaking their heads. And then they said to me, it's been knocked down. The place, the building that we opened, it was so long ago that it's now been knocked down, because it was, you know, 40 years later, 30, 35 years later. So there we are. Oh, there's loads of stories, but you caught me off guard. I don't know. It was great. It was really fantastic performing with Paul Rodgers as well. He's always been one of my heroes. What a singer. What a singer. Nothing like Adam Lambert. Nothing like, just different. You know, he's a blues. He's a blues singer. And what a blues singer, you know.
It's different. Oh, I mean, on a level of.
Yeah, he could just sing anything. Adam Lambert's really impressive as well. And he's flamboyant and he's got a great stagecraft. Maybe more so than Paul had, but bloody hell, what a voice Paul's got. And he's a lovely guy as well. And his wife, Cynthia. They're both really nice people. We had a lot of nice times together on, you know, we used to fly in sort of private jets, and we'd spend a lot of time together just chatting on those flights. It's a lovely time. It was a good time, yeah.
They have different kind of talents, Adam and Paul, right?
Yeah, completely. Mm-hmm. Completely, yeah.
Allora, qual è il concerto che ti ha impressionato di più, diciamo, durante la tua carriera, anche con Brian e Roger?
During your career, what was the concert that got you impressed the most?
One that I played or somebody else's concert?
No, in your career.
Oh, I see. We did one with Queen in Hyde Park.
Okay.
And we did another one at the Hollywood Bowl in Los Angeles, which was great. And Slash got up and played with us. And he did Tie Your Mother Down, I think. And he probably did Can't Get Enough of Your Love. Mm-hmm. You know, the Free song?
Yeah.
Can't get enough of your love.
I know that.
and the solo. Oh, I can't remember it. I can't remember who it is. Because it's
fantastic.
Anyway, it's a harmony guitar solo, which I usually do with Brian.
Oh.
And so I had to teach it to Slash.
Oh.
About what to play, because he was going to come on and do my parts.
Mm-hmm.
I was still on there on the stage, but just. He'd go out the front with Brian and do the harmony guitar part. So that was a joy. He's a great guy, Slash. He's a good friend. Yeah, that was a good one. The Hollywood Bowl.
Okay. Hey,
con Brian e Roger, cosa si prova? Che emozione ti ha dato?
How does it feel to work with Brian and Roger? What was it like to work with them?
Well, at first, of course, it's a bit scary because they're you know, it's the biggest band in the world, isn't it?
Assolutamente.
I guess.
Yeah.
Them or the Rolling Stones, don't know. But so scary at first, but once you get to know them and know them as people, it's a lot easier because you're just friends and you're in a band playing together, like when I was a kid and I played with my friends in a band. And it's just a nice friendly and it's a happy thing to do because you're creating music together. So yeah. But I was very lucky to do it.
Indeed. I can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
Jamie, cosa ne pensi delle qualità vocali di Roger?
What do you think about Roger's vocal skills? Because we know wide range.
He's got a really high range. He can sing much higher than I can, for sure. I think it was him that on all the very high stuff that Queen did, I think he was doing all those top parts. Like, wow. We will not let you go, let him go. All those high parts up there.
Yeah.
I think that's Rog. Yeah, he's a great singer. Great singer. Yeah. But of course, when Fred was around, you didn't need anybody else to come out the front and be the singer because you got Fred. You know.
Yeah. Perfetto. Jamie, Queen con Paul Rogers o con Adam Lambert, abbiamo capito già da prima che preferisci Paul Rogers, ma cosa ne pensi di questi due personaggi?
Okay, about Queen with Paul and Queen with Adam, we kind of understood that you prefer Paul, but what do you think of them?
No, don't prefer either of them. They're just different. They're just different. They're both fantastic singers and performers, you know.
So you think they both have a different kind of voice, but they're equally talented, right? Mm-hmm. So that's your impression on them.
Yeah.
And in general, what do you think of them, of their stage character?
Well, Adam, as I said earlier, is very flamboyant. He's a great entertainer. And, you know, all the robes and the crown and the stuff, which is, it's kind of an extension of what Freddie did. So he is moving in that territory, in that mm-hmm. world. Whereas Paul Rodgers didn't even try to do any of that because he knew that that wasn't him. He's basically a blues and soul singer. And the way he holds the mic and does all that kind of thing, this was the approach that people like Wilson Pickett and Otis Redding, you know?
I've been singing with my band, across the water, across the land. I see every blue eyed Lucy all the way. But their beauty and their style were kind of smooth after a while. Take me to their naughty ladies every time. Oh, won't you take me home tonight?
Veronica, allora digli che per quanto riguarda me, io preferisco quando i Queen suonavano con lui e Paul Rodgers, perché c'era una chimica, si intendevano tra di loro e poi musicalmente erano molto molto meglio e molto potenti come musica. Si intendevano a meraviglia.
He personally prefers Queen with Paul. Because he feels that there was a sort of chemistry between the band members. They had some sort of, you know, the playing in general was very powerful. And yeah, that's why he prefers Paul.
I see.
And yeah, I don't have a preference either. I prefer both.
No, I think part of the thing is that with Paul, Brian and Roger and Freddie, to a great degree, really were big fans of Paul Rodgers and of Freeze. And Freddie just loved Paul's voice. So, you know, they felt that it's, in a way, it's what Freddie would have wanted, you know, for him, for his take place to be taken by Paul Rodgers. Freddie would have gone, wow. So they looked up to Paul as one of their, not only their equal, but someone who you know, was around before they were singing great and having success. So,
Ma pensi che un giorno Paul Rodgers canterà ancora con Brian e Roger? Oppure no?
Do you think that one day we will be able to see Paul on stage with Queen, with Brian and Roger, even just to sing one song? Do you think that could be happening one day?
Why not? Everybody's still friends. Yeah.
Oh, that's good to hear.
Yeah, Spike sees Paul a lot because Spike has a place in California, very, very near to where Paul lives.
Ok,
Jamie, tu, Danny Miranda e Spike Edney eravate insieme con i Queen. Che rapporto c'era con tutta la band tra di voi?
Ok, you've been part of Queen together with Danny Miranda and Spike Edney. What was your relationship with these two people?
With Spike and Danny?
Mm-hmm.
Spike, like I say, I've known him since I was 17. And or 18, and And Danny was new into the whole thing, but he was fun. Danny, he made me laugh a lot. Yeah, good player. And he knew all the Queen stuff because I think he played in We Will Rock You in Las Vegas. So he really knew all the Queen songs. He's very good at all that. But yeah, no, we had a lot of fun. The three of us call ourselves the Three Amigos. And sometimes the dressing room sign, you know, Paul, Brian would have his own dressing room, Roger, Paul Rogers, and then we would share one and it would say the Three Amigos.
Ok.
Ok, Jamie. Allora, hai lavorato con i Queen, con Paul Young, con Gary Barlow, dei Take That, e altri mostri sacri della musica. Cosa ti porta dentro questa esperienza?
Okay, so you worked with Queen, Paul Young, Gary Barlow from Take That, and other great performers. You played several times with the SAS band. So, what good memories do you have from these experiences, from all of this?
Oh, there's so much, so much. Oh, just loads and loads of stuff. Let's see. I have to pick an artist, really. Mike and the Mechanics. That was a
Oh, I know
yeah.
them.
I'll just tell you a little story, a brief story about that. We were sitting waiting for cars to take us from the hotel to the venue on tour. And there was a guy who came up, started talking to us. He was drunk, and he was like a businessman who was staying at the hotel. And he was going, "Oh, it's fantastic. Well, I've been here for 2 days, and you know, I've met loads of people." And he's just talking about his business and everything. And we're just going, "Yeah, where's the car to take us to the venue?" And then eventually he said to us, he said, "Oh, so anyway, what do you chaps do?" And Paul Carrack, you know Paul Carrack, the singer from Mike and the Mechanics?
Oh, yeah, I know Mike Rutherford from Mike and the Mechanics.
Yeah, no, Paul Carrack is a singer.
Okay,
He's
yeah. I started following Mike and the Mechanics because of Rutherford, because I'm a Genesis fan too. That's
me
why.
too, me too, me
Okay,
too. So that was
gracias.
great when I got with Mike and the Mechanics to play with Mike Rutherford. It's terrific. So
Yeah.
anyway, so this guy says to him, "So what do you chaps do?" And Paul Carrack said, looked at all of us. He said, "We're mechanics." And he said, "Oh, all right, oh, good. Well, bye bye." Off he went. So he thought we were like car mechanics or something. I don't know.
Jamie, ci fai una top 5 degli album rock che ti piacciono di più, quelli che preferisci?
Could you make us a personal top 5 of rock albums according to your taste? Your personal top 5 of.
Katie Lied by Steely Dan. October Road, James Taylor. Court and Spark by Joni Mitchell. Oh, Axis Bold as Love by Jimi Hendrix. What's it? Revolver, Beatles.
Okay.
That's a good list. That's a really good list.
Assolutamente. Jamie, la tua chitarra preferita, di quelle che possiedi tu?
Okay, among the guitars you own, what's your favorite one?
Probably that one.
Wow.
Oh.
Ah. Wow,
It's a Fender.
bello. It's a Fender Strat, which
Okay.
I bought it new in which I bought new in 1982, I think it was. And it's a Squire Strat.
Ah.
It was made in Japan, but it's one of the first Squire Strats. So, and it's all the original pickups, and that pickup cover changed color. I don't know why. But yeah, this does everything. I use it for just about everything. I used it a lot with Queen.
Mm-hmm.
And then that is because my eyes aren't so good. So they're like the fret markers here.
Ah, okay.
They're on the back, so I can see them from there when I'm standing on stage better. And then I've got that acoustic, which is just... It's a beautiful, beautiful sounding guitar. 1966.
Wow.
Gibson J45.
Wow.
That's my favorite acoustic. Always within arm's reach, both of them.
And I see you have the Red Special too. I have one too.
Oh, have you?
Yeah. Okay. Wait, it's here. There she is.
Left-handed.
But it's a left-handed one because I'm left-handed.
Because you're left-handed, brilliant.
Yeah, thank you.
Very good, very good.
Jamie, un ricordo del mitico Cozy Powell, leggendario batterista dei Rainbow e dei Black Sabbath.
Okay, he's asking you. I bet you do. Do you have any memories with Cozy Powell, who was the legendary drummer from Rainbow and Black Sabbath?
Mm-hmm. yeah, I do remember. I didn't see it, but he told me about it, that he was very friendly with Special Forces, SAS, mm-hmm. You know, the British Special Forces and soldiers and what have you. And they used to go, he lived on a farm in the middle of nowhere. They used to come and pick him up to take him, they just take him down the pub. And they'd come in a helicopter across the farm with a Jeep as well underneath like that, going down this dusty trail. I could see it. It must have been fantastic. And then they turn up just to take him down to the pub. It's quite an image, but aside from that, he was. What did he used to call me? Not fella. It was something. I can't remember. God. But yeah, the sitting down at the front of the bus shouting at other drivers. That's what really stuck in my head. He was funny. He's a very funny guy. Yeah, lovely. And great, great drummer. You always knew with Cozy, if something was about to happen, if he was playing and there was a change about to happen in the song, most people, a lot of drummers would go and that would be that. Cozy would go and you knew that it was going to go from the verse to the chorus or to another.
Aveva una tecnica veramente unica.
He said he had a very unique way of playing, a very peculiar technique.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I don't know about his pure, but I do know that a lot of drummers would come to the show to see him. Bobby Elliott from the Hollies, who I used to play with as well, he used to come to the shows. And yeah, he's a very well-respected drummer.
Hai partecipato al Pavarotti and Friends, puoi dirci cosa si prova a salire sullo stesso palco insieme a un grande tenore come Pavarotti?
Okay, you took part in the 2003 project Pavarotti and Friends, so how was it like to be on stage with the world's greatest tenor of all time?
Yeah, it was it's quite something. Of course, he found Brian's guitar very loud. And he's during rehearsals on the stage, sound check. Pavarotti didn't speak directly to people. He's got a man who Pavarotti would lean over and say something to this guy, to his musical director or something. And then the guy would come back and say what he wanted to say to us. And he came up, he said something to him. The guy came back and said, was talking to Brian. And Brian came over to me. I said, what's the deal? What's happening? He said, well, the maestro, because they call him the maestro, it says my guitar is too loud. But Brian, he gets that fantastic sound by being really loud. That's how he gets the sound. So and he said, what am I going to do? I can't really turn it down. I said, do what I do. Go over to your amp, pretend to turn the knobs down. You do that. And that's what he did.
Genius.
Yeah. Well, I didn't notice any difference in the volume when we actually came to do it. Because these were rehearsals. When we came to do it, it was Too Much Love Will Kill You, you know, the song.
And Brian was like, I know.
Too Much Love Will Kill You every time. You know, and Pavarotti's hair parted at the back. Fantastic. Yeah, it was a fun gig, that one. Oh!
Già, mi hai mai avuto l'occasione di vedere Queen con Freddie?
Okay, did you ever have the chance to see Queen with Freddie?
No, I didn't see them. I did one gig with Freddie,
Oh.
long before I met Brian. But it was just one, it was a thing at the Coliseum in St. Martin's Lane in London. It was a charity thing, and he was on stage with the Royal Ballet. And I was playing Crazy Little Thing Called Love that had just come out. So, yeah, but I never saw the band with Freddie, no.
Okay.
Jamie, ti piace l'Italia e ci vieni spesso? E anche quale artista italiano preferisci?
Okay, he wants to know, do you like Italy if you come here often and if you listen or you like Italian music? And if yes, what kind of Italian music do you listen to?
I don't know a lot of Italian music. I know Zucchero,
Ah, Zucchero. Okay.
yeah, because he's a friend of Paul's. So, you know, whenever I see him, it's good to see him. But other than that, I know Eros Ramazzotti, but I don't know much about him. But
Eros
some of my friends play with him. They play in his band. But I love, love, love Italian food. I love Italy as a country. I love the people. It's just the best. We've been to Tuscany 2 or 3 times on holiday. Rome, I love Rome. Had some very good times there. Yeah, like I say, the food, the wine. It's just yeah, there's very few places that can top Italy.
You ever been in Venice?
Yeah. In fact, and well, yeah,
I'm
I
from
did.
Venice.
You're from Venice, are
Yeah.
you? Oh, brilliant. Okay. No,
I
I've
live
done a couple.
2 hours from there.
Oh, nice, nice. Yeah, I've done a couple of gigs there. I did a TV show there with a band called Broken English back in the 80s. And then I did a show with the SAS band there about maybe 10 years ago, I guess, with Mel C from the Spice Girls and a few others. And my daughter was there last week in Venice. She was there with her husband, who's a sax player. He plays with Madness and with Noel Gallagher.
Oh, God.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but so she was there on holiday last week.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Good.
Ok, Jamie, guarda, abbiamo finito le domande, siamo veramente emozionati ad averti qui, è stato un grandissimo piacere e ti ringraziamo veramente con tutto il cuore.
Okay, the questions. We're done with the questions. So we thank you for your time. It was amazing to
Lovely.
have you here. And so, yeah, anytime you want.
Yeah. No, it was good fun. Good questions and well done.
Thank you.
Let me know when it comes out and whatever. Okay.
Jamie, l'ultima domanda, che album preferisci di Queen? Così.
One last question, quick. What's your favorite Queen album?
I think A Night at the Opera.
Mm. Yeah.
I think that was, yeah, I bought that one and I bought A Day at the Races and I think one other one, long before I knew I'd ever be playing with them, you know. But it's the one I know best is Night at the Opera. So probably that one.
Fantastico. Grazie, Jamie. Grazie veramente di tutto, eh. Sei un
Thank you.
grande. Sei un
Thank you
grande.
for everything.
My
Ah.
pleasure and take care. Stay well.
Grazie, grazie. Ciao Jamie, grazie mille. Ciao Jamie.
Thank you.
Ciao
Bye
Jamie.
bye.
Ciao.
Bye.
Ciao.